Hi, good morning. Thank you so much for joining me in my shop here on May 29th. And what I'm going to be... Oh, what is that? Wait a minute. Okay. So, what I'm going to be doing this morning is examining, using some instruments, the situation with the alignment or the tuning of the radio, in hopes of finding out why it has this oscillation that breaks out anytime I try to peak up the IF stages in the radio. Now, radio's working, it's actually working pretty good, and if I were to just detune the IF a little bit, I could probably escape the oscillation, but at the same time I'd be reducing the performance of the radio. And although it's hard to tell, it looks to me like it's a significant loss in performance. So what I'm going to do here, and I got to put the camera back again so you can see enough. Maybe if we go up a bit, might help a little bit. So here I have a sweep generator, and it's operating right now, and it's sending out a sweep signal focused on the IF frequency of the radio. So the IF frequency is 455. This guy is starting at 420 and ending at 490, roughly. So it's putting a sweep out into this separate coil or antenna. It's an antenna from another radio, and I just have it sitting in proximity to the antenna here, or to the radio here, in the hopes of getting some of the signal from the signal generator into the radio in the easiest way possible, which is just to drive it in through the speaker. It's out of the range that the radio should be receiving through its antenna, but not so far out that it can't be done. So what I've done also, you're looking at the SDR, my SDR radio. The SDR antenna is amongst of that yellow clip lead that's wrapped around the detector tube. The detector tube is sitting at the output of the IF, where the IF signal is the strongest. The radio's not switched on yet. Now, if you've been looking at the SDR, you've been seeing something happening right up in here. So this is the IF frequency, right? I can't put my finger up there. But you can see something traveling across, and on the waterfall display, you can see it fairly clearly. Hey, maybe I can do this kind of thing. You can see the on the waterfall, you can see it slowly move over. I have the sweep set to one second right now, or maybe it's even, no, you know what, it's set to 10 seconds. So we're getting an idea of the sweep. Now, with the radio not operating, I really don't want to see this original sweep signal. What I want to see is what is occurring in the IF itself. So the output of the IF is going to show up on the display along with this. But this is turned up quite high right now. In fact, I think you could use the term full blast. I got full blast output from here in order to see that. So I'm going to turn this back a bit, like that, and I bet you we'll stop seeing it. So the other thing I want to do is I want to zoom in on this area on my SDR. So I'm going to zoom. Okay, so this is 500 here, and this is 400 here, 455, so I'll put the red line on it. 455. So that's the ideal center tuning of the IF. And hopefully we're going to have a sweep just roll right through here. I'm going to turn it back up again so we can see it. There it is. Now I'm not going to do this at this speed. I'm going to turn it up much, much faster. Why don't I do it now? We'll see what happens. So you're not seeing it on the SDR anymore. Good, that's good. So if we see something on the SDR at this point, we know it's actually coming out of this radio and not just coming from the signal generator. Perfect, I think. Well, we'll see if this works. It may not even work. Also, I can close couple the antenna, but if I do, wow, that's interesting, eh? So that's better. Now we can see the actual sweep. Again, it's being picked up directly by the coil sitting here, which we don't want in the end. So you see how it's all shimmery and it's, you know, kind of wobbly and doing all this jerky stuff. That's the SDR automatic level control attempting to deal with a sweep coming through like this. Now I can make that look a little nicer if I just turn off the decay, turn off the decay and let it build. And we end up with that. It's a little like, you know, in astronomy, it's a little like stacking photographs, what I've done right now. So, okay, and the sweep tips upwards, well, that could be for any one of a number of reasons. We can't be sure. Now, to get rid of it, I have to turn the decay back on, even just a little bit. Slow it down as much as I can. Okay. That's what's coming at the radio. Turn it down again until we don't see it. Well, I can't really do that, can I? Yeah, way down here. Way down. We just leave a little bit on there. Because I expect the radio's own signal to come in and just ramp that rate back up, only it won't be in the same shape. Okay, let's give it a go and turn on the radio. No, you know what? I'm going to stop for a coffee break. Yeah, coffee break time. Then I'll turn on the radio. Okay, we're all ready to go here. I am thoroughly coffeed up. Hey, I'm a member of the Coffee Achievers. Here we go. Coffee Achievers. So when I was a young lad, many moons ago, I'd be watching TV in the morning as a kid, watching cartoons and stuff like that, and these ads would come on for the Coffee Achievers. Join the Coffee Achievers. So if you don't know what I'm talking about, type into YouTube in the search thing, Coffee Achievers, and look for some of these ads I'm talking about that were put in front of me, and maybe even you, when I was much younger, trying to encourage me to drink coffee. Oh my God, it worked! I drink coffee all the time. Okay, no I don't. Just drink coffee in the morning. Okay, let's hear what's coming out of the speaker. Okay, that's the buzz. You can see something on the SDR already too, you're probably looking at. That's the buzz from this. So if I turn this down, buzz goes down. Why is it buzzing? Because essentially there's a blip traveling through the IF, past the tune spot and back. That's causing an output. It's causing an output from the IF, which is causing the AVC to shift. And I believe, myself, it's the shift in the AVC that we're hearing. It's shifting very fast, and it makes that buzz. Maybe there's a better explanation for it, why we hear the buzz during this. If I stop the sweep entirely, of course, it all goes away. Okay, now the sweep also is not modulated. It's an unmodulated carrier sweeping through the IF. Well, we do see something there. What is that that we see? Let me turn this up. Now, bearing in mind, the way I have this arranged, it's going to start revealing the underlying signal, but maybe the radio signal will just beat it all the time. It's kind of riding on top, isn't it? So you see a squarish thing here, and we know that's the actual signal coming right out of the signal generator going right in the SDR, and then impressed on it is right up in this area is the bump of the response curve. Not quite what I wanted. I'd like to see the response curve a little bigger than that. Let's see if we can do it. So if I put this further away, this is probably not going to help. Let me turn this up more. I'm just going to get the same effect again and again here. Okay, accepting what we have there. What is that telling us? So, I'm going to stop the decay of the image and let it build up. Yes, sir. What can I do for you? Now, we don't have to have this up at all. So there we are. a disturbed, somewhat disturbed wave shape there. I believe the SDR's internal automatic adjustments are affecting the display. It's not the classic, curve, beautiful curve like that. It's some distorted thing. There is a peak. Where is the peak occurring? So I've got 455. I've got this red line set at 455. You can see the peak of this display is a little bit beyond that. And it's not at all a smooth rise and a fall. But that's probably because of the SDR itself. I've got a cat patiently waiting for me down there. Peanut, what's up? So the door is open upstairs to the deck. Now he could go anytime he wanted. The reason he's sitting there is because his food bowl is empty. He can't do anything. Hey, Peanut, you want some food? You want some food? Good cat. Yeah, that's quite the response there. Okay, I'm going to have to stop here for a moment and go and give him some food. Okay. Okay, my cat's crunching away upstairs now. Happy cat. And it is just beautiful outside, and I got to get out there. So, so the advantage of using the SDR is that the frequency is shown right on the screen. That's as opposed to using, trying to do this in a classic way using a scope, which I think we're heading for anyway. The problem with the scope is you don't know what frequency is where. So the problem with the SDR is it's probably distorted a little bit, and also the way I'm feeding the signal in is a little bit of a sloppy way of doing it. Well, we can do a couple other things here. One is we can feed this signal directly in. Let's do that. Turn this down, way down. I'm going to disconnect from here. Now we would want to feed it kind of directly into the antenna a couple ways. One is to just hook the live wire up, and we'll see what we get from that. I've got to turn this back on over here. A little bit of a decay. There it goes. Now we'll put this back up. Well, no response from the radio itself. Like just the flat with no peak showing. Why would that be? With a harder signal here. Why no response curve there? At least not one that can be seen. So I guess what's happened now is the whole signal from the sweep is just as strong as a response curve. Well, we're going to try attaching a ground here. Getting just a little bit more on the risky side for my instrument. Let's turn this down. And right here. Well, that's a little different. But we're not getting any clear response curve effect there. We can't really do much with this. Has not worked out as well as I had hoped, but you know, every time I do this, I get a little bit of a different response. Different radios behave differently. So the shape is there. It's just right here, and we can't do anything with that, I don't think. Okay, let's turn this down. Take the signal off. Take the ground off. So, what we should try now is using the oscilloscope to see the same effect. I can hook the oscilloscope to the speaker, believe it or not, and we can see something, or I can hook it up to the an AVC point, low impedance AVC point, which shouldn't disturb the radio. So let's try hooking it up somewhere in the radio here. So first I need to cut the radio off before I get it electrocuted. I don't want to get electrocuted. I'm generally trying to avoid electrocution while I'm in here. Let's let's not tip it. You know what? If you tip this radio up onto this side here, you know, tip it up sideways, it'll end up resting to some degree right on this. I wonder if that's what broke it off in the first place. So we'll tip it up the other way. Hey, maybe that's what broke it off. Having that happen right there. I thought this was stable. Not particularly. Ever play with blocks when you were a kid? I did. Now I have a nice set of wooden blocks over here. Okay. So we're going to want to hook up to the oscilloscope. So we're going to get an oscilloscope lead. Now, when the oscilloscope is operating, normally it derives a sweep signal internally, but when I'm using this device, this guy will get his sweep from here. And this is designed to do this. There's a special setting. That's the special setting there. And now this input no longer causes a amplitude response. This input controls the horizontal position of the dot. This is going to send over a sweep signal. You can't see, but it says right on there, sweep output. And this cable disappears and reappears, and you can't see it, reappears over here. So that's what's going on. Let's turn on the scope here. We're going to put this on a low impedance point. I think we need to peek at the schematic. I can just kind of pop it up on the SDR screen there. How about a schematic? Here we are. And what we're looking at right here at the output of the IF, where can we hook up an oscilloscope without throwing everything off? And the ideal place would probably be right here. Right at the top of the input side of the volume control, which is quite common. Should be able to hook up there. The scope should not disturb the radio much. If you try to watch this, like watch the ABC voltage on the other side of this great big resistor here, the 2.2 megohm resistor, then the scope may drain too much charge out of this part of the circuit and it won't operate the way it was intended. The scope will throw it off. But up here, I think we can get away with it. But we will find out. So we'll leave the radio on its side and we'll practice here before putting the power on. The volume control's down here. This just doesn't get any easier to do. Or does it? Yeah. Now the input side here is going to be this green wire right here, coming right out of the IF on this black wire. Oh, let's look at the schematic. Right out of the IF on a black wire. It's exactly right. And we want to clip this onto B minus, not onto the chassis. So we'll use the negative from the capacitor to spot that. This will be B minus. A little scary, you know, clipping right into a radio, but I've done this enough times. Just making absolutely sure, because it's an important circuit there not to. So what I'll be able to do is, at some point, is finish the sentence. I'll be able to finish the sentence. If I'm going to do this, click, 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 on and off, with this guy set to the times 10 setting, and we'll see if it affects the radio or not, and I don't think it will. Okay, here we go. Power on to the radio. Burning a nice spot into my scope here, aren't I? Let's just keep it moving for now. Until we're ready to just a little quicker. Ooh, a little quicker. And maybe a little duller. Maybe just a little duller. I feel better. Okay, Mr. Radio, you should be on. Sounds a lot quieter, doesn't it? Did I forget something? I forgot the Jim, you're losing it. What are you trying to do? We want to feed this in. Again, we could just feed it into the antenna in this radio. Now we've got two grounds here. Danger, danger, danger. Danger, Jim. So, you know, I could stick this ground on the chassis, probably wouldn't cause any serious trouble, but really this ground should go the same place as the other ground. On the end of that black wire. It's getting kind of crowded. How am I going to do that?
Well, there's lots of places. Wherever this brown wire travels is part of the grounding. I believe to be the case. Now, here's a brown wire with a whole bunch of red ones hooked up to it. That doesn't fit the pattern very well. So if I just trace this a little bit here. Brown wire. Okay, there's another good spot. I think I can clip it there. Okay, I'm going to cut the power off just because, you know, even though you're not going to get a shock, if you get a splash or a spark or a pop, it'll make you jump. And at that point, you're throwing the radio somewhere. I don't want that to happen. So this is basically the same B minus. It's the B minus bus. We can put it that way. These clip leads have a way of just disconnecting themselves. Okay, as long as I don't fiddle with that. And then this is going to be on the antenna input. One of these was a long antenna, one was a short. I don't know which is which. We'll just go on one of them. Okay, then we'll cut down the input quite a bit. Okay, so we're ready. The sweep is sweeping. We're going to try to sweep the IF with an IF signal pumped in through the antenna and watching the effect on the and the output of the IF ahead of where it's turned into an AVC capacitorized voltage. Now, so it's going to go on the input wire, which is this green one. Now it's going to do this. Okay, back on. So this time, the sweep may cause a buzzing sound in the radio. Just leave the schematic there for now. Not as dramatic as I would have thought. Oh, I see why. Okay, we don't want to listen to it. Now, oh, we do need to listen to it to find out if this is disturbing. Turn this way down. Any disturbance from you? And I'm going to put this on times one. Even on the times one, we don't have much. I don't hear anything really. No significant disturbance from the equipment. Okay. We'll leave it on the times one for now. Clip on. And I was doing that. You weren't looking at the oscilloscope, and there wasn't much to see. I'll set this to the sweep from here. And we'll get this guy sweeping. It should be sweeping right now. Why not? Uh-oh. What has gone wrong here? What have I done wrong? I have the stop button here. You can hear the sweep going through the radio. Why am I not seeing it over here? Because this is on ground. That would be a little better. Okay, and then we have to center it. Okay, there's a line going across there. This isn't the best way to show him, but now, what do we want to see? We want to see a response curve on there. So I'm going to up the signal strength here. The response curve's way out here. What's going on? Apparently I'm not sweeping the IF properly. That's what it would look like. We'll stop it. This is the start frequency, 415, that's way below. And this is the stop frequency, 483. We can go a little bit higher on that. It's not making a lot of sense what's happening here.
I'm doing something wrong.
What am I doing wrong?
AC.
It's still way down here.
You know, this is suggesting the IF is tuned to 440.
Really? Really? Is that the...
Yeah, you know what? I have not done this with an instrument, have I?
I have not.
So, the IF is way off.
Okay. Very good.
Once again, we don't need to listen to it. Well, you know, I have no real reason to doubt this. What I'll do is I'm going to set the start frequency here lower. So we'll go to the start frequency of 415, and we'll set it lower. Like, how about 375? How about that, 375? Okay, 375. Look at where the sweep is. Wow. Why so big? That's better. Well, look at the strange shape we're getting now. We're getting the classic curve, and then we're getting this. And then we're getting backed up. This, you know, there's four tuned circuits here we're looking through. We're looking through four tuned circuits. And one of them, I can't raise my pinky. I'm trying to raise my pinky up. Like British tea time or something here. So one of them is way off. You bring that back, this will disappear, and this will become sharper. And what do you want to bet that's something to do with the oscillation? Is that the oscillation? Can we see the oscillation when we do this? Hey, great questions. I don't know. I'm going to turn this down just a wee bit. Or better yet, I'm going to raise the whole display upwards here. So we get a good look at it. Now I'm going to attempt. Oh, good luck to me. I know you're looking at it from a far distance, but that's okay. You're still seeing it. I'm going to try now to adjust the IF on this radio, and we'll see if we can't clean this thing up. Now, the problem again is I don't know for sure that this is 455. That's a pretty good problem. We really need to know where 455 is, because maybe it's here, and all these guys are wrong. When you do that ear tuning thing, you don't use instruments. You get them lined up on something, but it won't necessarily be the correct frequency, and you really can't tell. Well, there are some tricks to tell, even without all this equipment, but I won't get into that. Okay, what to do next? Do the IS. I think we're all set. Okay. I'm going to go right to that one that I've been adjusting, the one trimmer I've been adjusting the entire time that causes the oscillating effect. Okay, here we go. I'm in. You can kind of see my left hand there. Here, now, watching the display, though, oh, I'm not in. I'm caught on the edge. Come on. Okay, now I think I'm in. Oh, did you see the change? There's the oscillation. That, or what is that? No, that's something wild anyway. You know what? That's exactly it. When I turn it this way, I'm turning it towards the oscillation problem, and all of a sudden, schwing, away she goes. I turn it back, and I need to know where the 450, where 455 is on here. So to do that, I have to turn on another signal generator. Turn on this big guy here. Set him up to 455. Have that signal mixed in here so I can spot it. All I gotta do is just a little calibration thing, and then I can turn it back off. So this is going to have the other signal generator signal on it. I'm going to want to mix it in. It doesn't even have to go through the radio. It just has to show up on the scope. What if I put it right on the scope? I feed it in right where the scope is. The problem now is scope is very high impedance. This is very low impedance. Like this is like a million ohms, the oscilloscope lead. Million or 10 million? Maybe it's 10 million? It's 1 million. It's 1 million on the scope. If I put this on, it's 50 ohms. It'll kill everything. So we can't go there. So we can feed it in. We can feed it in. We can feed it in right with the antenna. Okay, so maybe even just look what I got right in front. No, I didn't get in front here. So this is me hooking up this line. So first you see a fairly clean display. And when I hook this up, it just turns into a whack of noise here. I'm going on the other capacitor. Where's the DC coming from? What's happening here? How come that went down like that? I don't know. Okay, we got another ground, which I have to connect to the same sort of grounding line. Oh my gosh, where am I going to go now? Okay, I gotta change. This is getting a little hairy down here. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna bring out on a clip lead the. Let me get a white one here. And you know why I've picked white? You don't know. I don't know either. So that makes two of us. I'm gonna cut the power off while I do this. I'm gonna disconnect the ground. The B minus line, let's not use that term ground, and B minus line. I'm going to hook up this clip lead to the B minus right there, and then everybody goes on the clip lead. Everybody else onto the clip lead. You might think of this as some kind of star grounding, but not really. And so there's one more. Where's the other one? There it is. Everybody's grounded in the same spot. This guy popped off. He popped off of this one right here. And the output from here's got to go down before we blow something up. Okay. Power back on. That sound is now. I heard yesterday I reacted to a sound here. So I have a ham radio in the back of my shop tuned to the local repeater. It's a 2 meter radio tuned to the local repeater, and but I have the volume turned right down. You can hear it sounds like sounds like something radioactive over there. That's the squelch opening and closing. Now, why it's doing that so rapidly, I don't know. But normally I can just hear pop, 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 and then I know people are talking on the radio. I don't have to listen to them, though. Okay, that explains everything. Everything's explained. I'm done. No, wait a minute. So we want to see... This is very tricky. First of all, this is full of other signals. How am I going to see this other signal amongst all these other signals? Just too much in there. Okay, it's not really the best way to look at it, but let's go with it because I'm rushing. You should never rush, but I am. I'm rushing a little bit. I'm not rushing, I'm hurrying. That's different. Okay, now I will turn up the output on the other signal generator. We can call this the marker generator. You can see the tremendous effect it just had. And I'm going to tune the marker generator, which currently is at 1481. That's nowhere near where I want it. 467 now. I'm going to turn it down. I'm going to watch the display. See, it just went wild there, and then it's gone. So you can't quite see my hand from this angle here, which would help a lot. I can just jam the camera in here. There, now you can see what I'm doing. Well, of Okay. So we're going to go. So right now, the frequency I'm putting out is way up here. I'm going to bring it down. As it gets into this zone, the whole display will just go wacko. Here we go. We're going down. We're going the wrong way. Okay, I'm actually below it. I'm down here. Coming up. That's what I'm doing. Coming up. You can kind of tell it's right here. I can tell because I've done this so many times. A little higher. See, the display has just gone crazy. Now it's coming back. Let me get it back to where it's crazy. And I can see it. It's right in here. And what is the frequency? 450. But we want this peak to happen at 455. Now, I'm going to make a few changes here. And you're supposed to do these things when you're doing alignment with low signals. Well, fooey on that. First, I'm going to get rid of the marker. Is this an oscillation already? No, it is. It's signals being tuned in on the radio. So we're going to go to a low signal spot. Yeah, it's 943. Wait a minute. Where'd it go? How come it just suddenly disappeared there? Everything seemed to change suddenly. Why did the display change? Oh, now you can't see the display. So I should really have another camera going. But no time for that. So I was tuning the radio, looking for a silent spot, and this whole picture changed. Is that because I had it in a certain spot that was... something like that. The question would be, what happened to the response curve? Well, there it is. Whoop. Okay, I've got this guy turned up pretty high. Well, doesn't go any higher. That's better. Now we'll try to swing the other signal in again. I'm gonna get a better view of where 455 is. Is it 455? Well, you probably have to trust me on this because you can't see what I can see. Right here. So this peak, this dip, to be here. We got to move it over there. So it looks like some coil's high. We don't need to listen to it. Some coil's high. Some coil's low. Okay, so we're aiming for in here. There we go. One by one. We're going to move these over. Okay, starting with the first one. Easy to shove a screwdriver into these trimmers and actually not go in the slot of the screw, but go beside the screw. There we go. Wow. That just... doesn't that look a lot better? But I don't think we're over far enough. Let me turn up the... tell where it is. It's still here. I'm going to stop for a minute and put a better camera on that. It's so interesting and you're not seeing it. Okay, I think we're much better off now. Take a look at that display while I monkey around with the radio. And other stuff in here. So, once again, how is it I know that the peak is right here? So I'm going to vary the other signal generator. You can watch it go back and forth. Now, you know, in a classic setup, you try to achieve a pip on here. So you'd have the marker generator would create a small pip or a line like this. And then you could really see where it is. But that's not going to work for me. Instead, we're just going to look at the amount of scrambling going on. It's very scrambled reading here. As I move it across, the scramble will move down here and get bigger. And then it'll scramble less and less. Now you can see where it is, though. Let's give it a try. Is he full of crap or is he telling the truth? Okay, we're going towards the dip. And the scramble's getting... Well, it did something a little different than I expected. I'm going to go past. So you can kind of get an impression that it's right up in here right now. And that's 456. Let me just turn it back. So 455 would be about here. So, you know, really, it's right up in here. So we're trying to get this peak, this dip rather, to move over to the right. That's the objective. Okay, so we can get rid of the that. We want this to be just a little further over and for this thing to look much more balanced than it does now. It looks pretty good now, though. Okay, now to move it over, I can just move this camera over here. Okay, so I'm going to want to move. Did something just happen? Well, how come this just got, I moved it a bit and the whole thing got louder, and look at the display. Oh my gosh. Crank it down. Get away with a much lower signal input. That's lovely. That's lovely. Okay. Starting with that, what I would call the first trimmer for some reason. Hey, what am I bumping into here? I'm bumping into something. What did I do? To what we were doing here. What's going on? What is going on? What's happening there? I'm just lightly tapping the IF. Is something just barely hooked on here? Move this display down just a bit. Did I use a bad extent, bad clip lead here? Bad clip lead on the. Okay, there we go. Okay, that's sorted out. We'll keep the sound a little bit. Now, assumably, let's bring that, let's bring this guy in again, because... .455 puts it about there. Let's see if we can see it like this. Okay, so I would say it's here right now, about here, right in the bottom of the curve. That's 440, that's 450. Go up, 454, I was supposed to be outside really quick today. Where'd it go? I wasn't watching. It's right in here, it's right in this bend here. So we really want to be over in this area here with the response. Okay, back to what I was doing. This time it won't quit on me. This screwdriver is just too small. Get one that's ever so slightly bigger. Okay, I'm ready. Now we're moving, like there's four things in there. So we'll move the first one. They're all adding up. So you know, you're looking at the additive sum while you move the individual parts. And that's not easy. Okay, we get the next one. Oh, heavens be. Broke into oscillation. Great when I'm just getting it there. Let's go back. Okay, so we're right in the zone here where I want to be. But you see, all that's happening here is I'm peaking up the IF and it's just going to break into oscillation again. Okay, another one here. Cammed out. There we go. I would say there. And now the last one, this is the one that I've been monkeying with the most. Wow. Some interesting shapes. It's moderately important to get this right on the right frequency. Okay, so I think we lower them again. Here we go, starting at the start again. Starting on the first one. Oscillation. I don't know about this. Second one. Just total oscillation now. I don't know. Doesn't look good. Next one. Oscillations. Oscillations. It's probably... might be oscillating all through here, we just can't hear it. The other signal is stopping us from hearing it. Okay, let me get rid of the other signal. Oh boy. Okay, one more time through all four tremors. Screwdriver keeps falling out here. Here we go. That's number one. Number two here. Okay. I don't think it's oscillating, but we're getting where we need to go. I don't think it's oscillating. Number three in my particular order. Right over there now. Okay, number three again. And the last one. The one I've been using all the time here. There we go. Okay, I'm going to swing the other marker generator in there and put it right on top. By my estimation, it's sitting right on the peak now. Take a look at the frequency. Somewhere you can see it there, 455. We've got it, and I don't think it's oscillating. Okay, we need to strip off this equipment. It sounds like it's right on the verge of oscillating. Just has that characteristic ah-ah sort of sound. Okay, we can take this lead off. Nothing bad happened. We can take this guy off. It is all by itself now. Okay, lay it down. It's not all by itself. Still got this in here. Nice and hot. Maybe it's melted onto the tube, for crying out loud. Shouldn't leave these on too long. Sound like it's oscillating? There we go. What do we get? So you can hear the guy talking, and you hear this terrible squawky interference noise. And I think that's what it is. It's squawky interference. It's not the radio itself oscillating. So I think we've managed to get this thing aligned properly in terms of the IF, anyway. We're gonna go up to 860. So many noises, it's unbelievable. 860. Well. Heard better, but there we go. I think I managed to get this aligned reasonably well. The dial accuracy is pretty darn good, so I don't have to fool with the oscillator adjustment. The last thing I was twiddling it with there is the antenna trimmer. I wasn't doing it at the high end where you normally do it at the high end of the band. I'm doing it kind of in the middle, which is okay. And I think that's about it. I think that's as good as we're going to get this radio. Well, thanks a lot for watching. And you've kept me in my shop here far too late. Oh, it's only 10 o'clock. I thought it was much later. Only 10 o'clock. Let me turn this off. You know what? As soon as I turn this equipment off, back at the power system, they shut down one of the generators. I don't need it anymore. Very good. Well, thanks a lot for watching. It's another radio, not in its cabinet yet. But I have two more radios to work on here. And I have all these cabinets I gotta clean. Oh man, it's a great day. I'm going outside. So thanks a lot for watching, and we'll see you.